Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. We at Easy Dentistry are here to make the entire dental syllabus easy and interesting for students worldwide. हमारे चैनल पर सब लेक्चर्स फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट अवेलेबल है. आपको किसी टाइप की फीस नहीं भरनी पड़ेगी. सिर्फ आपको एक बात करनी है, वो ये कि हमारे चैनल को अभी सब्सक्राइब कर लीजिए और नोटिफिकेशन बेल भी ऑन कर लीजिए ताकि आप कोई लेक्चर मिस ना करें. तो आइए शुरू करते हैं आज का लेक्चर जो है एंटी कैंसर ड्रग्स पे. हमारे कई व्यूअर्स ने ये टॉपिक डिमांड किया था, तो ये टॉपिक ऑब्वियसली बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है. सो वॉच दिस लेक्चर अटेंटिवली. तो एंटी कैंसर ड्रग्स हम दो पार्ट्स में पढ़ेंगे, पार्ट वन एंड पार्ट टू. ये एक लंबा टॉपिक है, बड़ा टॉपिक है, इसलिए ये दो पार्ट्स में डिवाइड किया गया है. सो लेट्स बिगिन. सो व्हाट आर द एंटी कैंसर ड्रग्स? द एंटी कैंसर ड्रग्स आर द ड्रग्स विच ईदर किल द कैंसर सेल्स और मॉडिफाई देयर ग्रोथ. द एंटी कैंसर ड्रग्स आर वन ऑफ द मोस्ट toxic drugs which are used in therapy. There is limited selectivity of the drugs and cancer chemotherapy is a combined modality approach which includes surgery, radiotherapy, immunotherapy and chemotherapy. What are the aims of the chemotherapy? First aim is to cure or prolong the disease remission. And this is the primary treatment modality. The second aim is palliation, which aims at shrinkage of the tumor, alleviation of the symptoms and prolongation of the patient's life. And third is the adjuvant chemotherapy, which is used to mop up any residual malignant cells after surgery or radiotherapy. So these are the three aims of chemotherapy. Now let us study the classification of anti-cancer drugs. The anti-cancer drugs are classified in three systems. The first system of classification divides the anti-cancer drugs into alkylating agent, platinum coordination complex agents and the anti-metabolite agents. The alkylating agents include various types. First is the nitrogen mustards, which include mechlorethamine, cyclophosphamide, ifosfamide, chlorambucil and melphalan. The second type of the alkylating agents are the ethylenamine, which include thiotepa. The third type of the alkylating agents are alkyl sulfonates, which include busulfan, methyl hydrazine, which include procarbazine, nitrosourias, which include carmustine and lomustine, and triazine, which include dacarbazine and timozolamide. The second type of drugs are the platinum coordination complex, which include three drugs: cisplatin, carboplatin, and oxaliplatin. The third type of drugs are the anti-metabolites, which are again subdivided into three types: the folate antagonist, which include methotrexate and pemetrexate; purine antagonist, which include 6-mercaptopurine and 6-thioguanine; and the pyrimidine antagonist, which includes 5-fluorouracil, capecitabine and cytarabine. So this is the first system of classification of the anti-cancer drugs. The second system of classification divides the anti-cancer drugs into five categories. These are the microtubule damaging agents, topoisomerase 1 inhibitor, topoisomerase 2 inhibitor, antibiotics and miscellaneous. The third system of classification of the drugs classifies the anti-cancer drugs into targeted drugs and hormonal drugs. The targeted drugs are further classified as the tyrosine protein kinase inhibitors. Now, in this lecture, we will be studying the first system of classification of anti-cancer drugs, which divides the anti-cancer drugs into alkylating agents, anti-metabolites, and the platinum coordination complex. The other two systems of classification will be studied in detail in part 2 of this same topic to avoid confusion between the drugs. Now, let's study what is the general toxicity of cytotoxic drugs. The cytotoxic drugs, they act on the rapidly multiplying cells. The target molecule for the cytotoxic drugs is the nucleic acids, and these rapidly multiplying cells contain large amount of nucleic acids. The cytotoxic effect on various human tissues are on bone marrow. It causes depression of the bone marrow, granulocytopenia, agranulocytosis, thrombocytopenia, and aplastic anemia. All these results into infection and bleeding. On the lymphoreticular tissue, there is lymphocytopenia due to reduced cell-mediated and humoral immunity, and there is increased susceptibility of the patient to infections. Opportunistic infections sets in, such as candida, herpes zoster, cytomegalovirus infection, and toxoplasma infection. Then on GIT, the cytotoxic drugs causes stomatitis, diarrhea, hemorrhage due to increased rate of renewal of the GIT lining, nausea, and vomiting. On skin, it causes alopecia. On gonads, in males, it causes oligozoospermia and impotence, while in females, it causes reduced ovulation and amenorrhea. Now, on the fetus, the cytotoxic drugs causes abortion of the fetus, then fetal death and teratogenesis. Other carcinogenetic effects of the cytotoxic drugs are leukemia, lymphoma, and histiocytic tumors. This occurs due to reduced cell-mediated and humoral blocking factors. Hyperuricemia is another cytotoxic effect caused by the cytotoxic drugs, which causes massive cell destruction, neuropathy, cardiomyopathy, alopecia, and cystitis. Now, what are the oral complications of the cytotoxic drugs? These oral complications you should know by heart, because it is frequently asked in exams. So, important oral complication of the cytotoxic drugs are oral mucositis. This oral mucositis occurs due to increase in the cell turnover rate. And trauma to the tissue occurs while chewing. There is increase in the oral microbial flora, and periodontal abscess are common. Neutropenia and reduced immunity causes more oral infections by low-grade pathogens such as candida and pseudomonas. Thrombocytopenia may result in gingival bleeding. This gingival bleeding should be checked by use of antifibrinolytic drugs or platelet transfusion if the count of the platelet is truly very low. Then xerostomia occurs due to the cytotoxic drugs. This xerostomia causes increase in the incidence of caries. Then angulochelitis and dysgeusia, that is loss of taste due to damage of taste buds, also occur as a complication of cytotoxic drugs intake. Now, chemotherapy in children result in hypoplasia of the developing teeth, blunting of the roots of teeth, and tooth agenesis. Now, thorough dental checkup should be done before starting with the chemotherapy. Any active caries lesions or periodontal lesions, any impacted molars, any sharp cusps or dentures should be properly treated. Then, stomatitis and oral ulcers can be treated with the use of chlorhexidine mouthwash. Candidal infection during chemotherapy can be treated by nystatin and clotrimazole. Mucositis is treated by topical application of sucralfate and misoprostol. Benzocaine topical application and lidocaine topical application causes reduction in pain. Opioid analgesics are another mode of therapy to reduce pain in the patients. Systemic antibiotics against Pseudomonas, Klebsiella and E. coli are administered. In a patient undergoing chemotherapy, if you want to do any dental treatment, you should obtain a consent from the patient's physician. And while performing the dental treatment, prophylactic antibiotics are administered to eliminate the risk of infection. Now, let us study the anti-cancer drugs in detail. For in this part, we will be studying the first system of classification of drugs, which divides the anti-cancer drugs into alkylating agents, platinum coordination complex, and the anti-metabolites. First, the alkylating agents. The mechanism of action of the alkylating agents is to produce highly reactive carbonium ion intermediates. These carbonium intermediates transfer alkyl group to cellular macromolecules by forming the covalent bonds. By formation of the covalent bonds, the position 7 of the guanine residues in DNA is specifically become susceptible, and cross-linking and abnormal base pairing or scission of the DNA strand occurs. The alkylating agents have cytotoxic and radiomimetic activity, and though these drugs are not cell cycle specific. So being not cell cycle specific, the alkylating agents, they act on the dividing cells as well as the non-dividing cells. The alkylating agents include cyclophosphamide, which are the most commonly used ones. They are effective against a wide range of tumors. They are prominent immunosuppressant. And chloramphenicol, it increases the metabolism of cyclophosphamide. Then the chlorambucil, it is selective on the lymphoid tissue, and it is used in the maintenance therapy of chronic lymphocytic leukemia and Hodgkin's disease. Busulfan is selective for the myeloid elements, and it is the drug of choice of chronic myeloid leukemia. Melphalan, it is used in the treatment of multiple myeloma. Lomustine is used in the treatment of brain tumors and meningeal leukemia. Dacarbazine is used in the treatment of malignant melanoma. Procarbazine is used in the treatment of Hodgkin's lymphoma because it depolymerizes the DNA in the lymphoid cells. The next group in the classification is the drugs which are the platinum coordination complex. This includes the cisplatin. Cisplatin is hydrolyzed intracellularly to release highly reactive moieties. This causes cross-linking of DNA and react with the SH group of the cellular proteins. These drugs have alkylating and radiomimetic property, and it is used for solid tumors of lungs, bladder, esophagus, stomach, head neck face tumors, and metastatic testicular and ovarian carcinomas. Now, the cisplatin can be infused IV, and it is highly emetogenic. Carboplatin is less reactive than the cisplatin, and it is better tolerated. Oxyplatin is the third generation platinum coordination complex, which is active against many tumors which are resistant to cisplatin. Now, the anti-metabolite group of the alkylating agents include the folate antagonist. The prototype drug of the folate antagonist is methotrexate. Methotrexate is the oldest and highly efficacious cytotoxic drugs, and it inhibits the enzyme dihydrofolate reductase. So this enzyme, the inhibition of this enzyme blocks the conversion of dihydrofolic acid to tetrahydrofolic acid. Now, this tetrahydrofolic acid is an essential coenzyme required for 1-carbon transfer reaction in purine synthesis and amino acid conversion. So, the production of this THFA is blocked due to methotrexate. Now, methotrexate, it inhibits DNA synthesis, affects RNA production and protein synthesis. Pentraxete is a newer congener of methotrexate and it is used in mesothelioma and non-small cell lung cancer. Purine antagonists are another type of anti-metabolite chemotherapeutic drugs, which include mercaptopurine and thioguanine, which are highly effective drugs. These drugs inside the body are converted into monoribonucleotides, which inhibit the purine synthesis and reduces the utilization of purine nucleotides. These drugs are mostly used in childhood cancers such as acute leukemia, choriocarcinoma, and solid tumors. Azathioprine has marked effect on T lymphocytes and it suppresses the cell-mediated immunity and it is a potent immunosuppressant in organ transplantation and rheumatoid arthritis. Fludarabine is a newer drug and it is particularly effective in slow-growing tumors. Adverse effects of the drug include bone marrow suppression, mucositis, jaundice and hyperuricemia. Now, the third group of antimetabolites are the pyrimidine antagonists. The fluorouracil is the prototype of this group and it acts on the nucleotide and thus blocks the conversion of deoxyuridylic acid to deoxythymidylic acid. Leucovorin and cisplatin have synergistic effect. And they are used in breast, colon, bladder, liver, head, neck, face tumors. Capecitabine is an orally active product of 5-FU and it is useful in colorectal and breast cancer. Cytarabine, it is phosphorylated into nucleotide and it inhibits the DNA synthesis by DNA polymerase enzyme. Uses of cytarabine is in acute leukemia, Hodgkin's disease and non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Here we complete with the discussion on the first system of anti-cancer drugs. In part 2 we will be studying the other drugs classification systems. Hope you enjoyed this lecture. That's all for now. Happy studying.